Hi guys, this what you see is a microwave transformer, and this is the primary winding from another similar microwave transformer from which I cut off this core. So today I'm going to use this primary winding to turn it into an electric generator. So guys, for magnets I'm going to use this armature that I modified into a magnetic rotor, and I have this 350 watts drill machine. This generator is going to generate AC. Now with that being said, let's start. Let's see the voltage. Let's do the generated current test. So for that I'm going to use this 1 square mm wire. So I have done the short circuit over here, and I have to keep the clips as apart as possible. We did around 3 volts AC, such a huge difference with and without core.
Here, as you can see guys, that I have connected 2 wires to one point, and then again the 2 wires to one point to increase up the short circuit current.
So starting with the current measurement for the core type. Wow. 3.45 amperes, almost 3.5 amperes, that was pretty good. So guys, now comes the part of using the neodymium magnets, and these are from the rotor of the e-rickshaw motor. You see, so many of them. Now, although I will have to cut this part off, okay, this one. So guys, here as you can see that I've cut off the rotor, and now it is free to use for many of my upcoming projects. It has super strong 8 neodymium magnets. That's the bearing and that's the holder. Placing it inside. This pipe, I'm going to place it on the shaft. It's not fitting perfectly. I will have to hammer it. So guys, your hidden question for the previous video is, why is silicon added to the steel core of the transformer? So guys, our experimental generator is ready now. Both at the front and at the back I've installed bearings, so it is running pretty smooth. As you can notice, I haven't used any core, so it is the coreless generator. Let's start the testing part. So guys, the multimeter has been connected and pointing towards AC voltage measurement mode. Let's give it a turn. Easily 0.7 volts. Easily 1.1 volts, pretty good, huh? 1.5 volts almost. So what I've done initially, it was only 2 poles, but now there are 8 poles, because of which for one single rotation of this rotor, too many inductions to the coil, and hence more voltage per turn. That is how low RPM is achieved. 1.6 volts, 1.997, 2.083 volts, crossed 2 volts with hand rotation. So guys, enough with the hand rotation, let's try my 850 watts drill machine. Okay, let's give it a spin. Oh, 13.5 volts AC, pretty good, huh? So moving on to the current measurement. Two amperes. Amperes coreless. So guys, here as you can see that I've connected this car headlamp bulb 12 volts. Let's see how bright it glows. Let's turn off the lights. Wow, once again. Pretty bright, huh? Now guys, it was really difficult to keep the core away from the neodymium magnet because the magnets are really strong. They are attracting the core towards them. Now that it has been done, I would really like to know the difference with and without core. Now there is some magnetic locking, of course, because of the presence of core. Let's see how it performs. Okay. Whoa! This time it was really bright. You see the difference? I think it is 4 or 5 times more bright now. That is how the core works. So guys, now that we have seen large power output from this generator setup, it's time to do the voltage and current measurement, and then we can figure out the maximum power output capability of this one. So guys, as you can see that I've connected the multimeter pins to the generator. Let's give it some hand spin. Easily 2.6 volts now. 2.6 again. 3.2. Yeah, 4.1 is the max I can do with hand rotation. Now let's do the drill machine test. I'm doing here 30 volts AC, and now you can see the difference for generators with and without core. Same is when you use it as a DC motor, you are going to get more torque with the core when compared to the coreless. And I'm just thinking that if I had like more coils like this one, I would place one at the top, one at this side, and one at the bottom, and then connect all of them in series. So 30 cross 4 making it 120 volts AC. It would be a proper generator. 120 volts generator AC. Starting it. was the max that I could do over here. I don't know the reason, but the power output seems to be somewhere around 100 watts. Increasing the RPM is not changing the current, but it is changing, like increasing the voltage, but the current is almost constant.